Asimbonanga.
Asimbonanga manje la tina la pe.
My question is, after experiencing all this horrific stuff in this prison, what is it that motivates you to come back and tell us your stories?
Thank you. Very good question. Because let me tell you this. 2003, I got a call from the ANC office. There is a meeting that you must go to Cape Town. Cape Town, yeah. I don't have money to go there. No, everything is organized. Then I came to Cape Town. They sleep me in the house. Then in the morning, comrades, the boat is leaving at 9 o'clock. Where to? Robben Island? No. No, what I'm going to do? No, the meeting is there. At the harbor, when it dock, everybody comes out. I was behind them. I was the last, and then I sit. While I was sitting, the captain of the boat came down and said, "Hey, Mr. Mabaso, the boat's not going to leave. You need to come out from the boat." I came out slowly. I woke up, and then people were waiting for me. Then they say, "This group is your group. You must just tell them how did you suffer, how did you live." I said, "What?" I said, "Talk to, you know how difficult it was?" Very difficult. I was so much crying most of the time. I couldn't express, but you know, it was so difficult. Then I remember Mr. Mandela said to us, "We need to rewrite our history. And we need to make sure that we write a new page." And I remember he mentioned something like the historians. Historians are writing things that they feel is good for them. But if we are not telling them, they will do that. So that's why I'm here. That's why I'm talking. But I must tell you, it's not easy.
He was very open, which struck me as something powerful. Just his experiences there were horrible, and the fact that he was able to speak about them so openly with us was really touching.
And it was just really fascinating to walk around with him and see a man who had been in that prison for so long and really experienced it. And you know, he showed us different hallways, different rooms, and told us really horrible things that had been done to him in each room. Mm-hmm. I think I was really impressed that he was able to still walk through those places and show us what had happened to him. He was able to relive it like that.
It was intense. It was unbelievable, something you can't even put into words, everything he's went through, and for him willing to come back to where he was horrifically tortured and tell us these stories tells us a lot about his character.